I'm going to present to you my story, some of the work that our organisation does, and some of the stories that I know and I've seen where football has had a massive impact in changing someone's life. Like any social project or most businesses, the idea for my organisation came from a personal experience. Now, if you look at that in the business world, you look at Skyscanner, an Edinburgh-born enterprise. That was born out of the founder travelling to see his brother in France all the time. And he found it an absolute nightmare to find cheap flights, so he created an Excel spreadsheet which would pull all the data into him, which enabled him to get the cheapest flights. So that's what powered Skyscanner. What powered my organisation was social change and the impact that football had in my life. 12 years ago, I was homeless in Glasgow. I grew up in an area of Govan, which is quite high deprivation, a lot of unemployment. My parents split up at an early age, and my father was an alcoholic. I grew up with no guidance. I had to support my father through difficult times. And I left school with no qualifications, floated through life until I got some sad news that my father had passed away. The impact on that, I totally lost it. I cut myself off from family and friends. I moved to another part of Glasgow. The stress and the problems that I was experiencing led to me turning to alcohol. It led me to breaking up the relationship I was in. And I just lost, my life spiraled out of control. When I was homeless, or if you can picture yourself just now being in that situation where you wake up or you're walking the streets and you don't know where you're going to end up. You don't know where you're going to lay your head at night. You have no hope, no self-esteem, no value. Now that's not just my story. That's happening outside as we speak. But that was my situation. But looking back on how did I actually change, how did I get from there to where I am today, I look back waking up having nothing to do, nowhere to be, no hope that things were going to change. But suddenly, football offered me an opportunity to mix with people, to have fun, to kind of take the weight off my shoulders and just be myself and do something that I enjoyed. And that took place in Glasgow, down at the local park, where me and 20 other people would meet up 2 days a week, play football, and it proved to be a real kind of change maker for me, because suddenly, rather than go out on a Monday night and get wasted or whatever you want to call it, go get involved with alcohol or negative behaviours, I would stay in. I would eat better so I could be better on the football pitch. Because suddenly I had a role model in my life, and the role model that I had was my coach. So at the age of 21, not having a role model in life, suddenly having that and having someone you want to impress so they'll pick you in the team is very valuable. That feeling of being part of something when you're homeless or you're excluded, it's horrible being out on the outside. There's almost that feeling of I don't belong here. I don't belong to be part of something good, because I'm useless. I'm bad. I'm terrible. Because that's what society. That's the position that society can place people in, and it's not nice. But football was that kind of wee spark that I had in my life, and when I came back, I went to the World Cup event in Sweden, and I met people from all over the world who had experienced far more worse scenarios than me. And I thought to myself, do you know something? Even though I was homeless, even though I had no opportunity or no education, I felt that I could change that. Whereas speaking to street kids in Namibia who don't have access to education, don't have access to basic human rights that we all take for granted, I thought to myself, well, you know something, David, it'll be tough, but if there's opportunities, take them, because other parts of the world, people don't have those opportunities. I came back to Glasgow after having a fantastic time. I was still homeless, but I had that spark. I wanted to change. I wanted to do something in my life. I was given opportunities along the way, which led to me becoming a football coach. Again, sparking a change from within inside me, because suddenly I was a role model to young people. So any negative behaviours that I was involved in get left behind. Because as I say, you practice what you preach. And that's what I was trying to do. It also helped me. As much as I helped the kids with their football coaching, I was being helped. I was feeding off their energy. And I had pride in myself. I also had the courage to go into education, having left the high school with no qualifications. I went to college and trained up as a community worker. Continuing the youth work and the football that I was doing, that proved to be my destiny as such. Some things happened for a reason. I always say being homeless was probably the best thing that ever happened to me, because it opened me to a world of realising what's outside your own door, realising that there's people in the world who are suffering, people who our society has left behind, and it made me want to become a change maker as such, to try and use the opportunity that I got to help other people. And then in 2009, I set up a social enterprise which would do that under the tagline Positive Change Through Football. I was full of gratitude, the fact that this simple football and this simple pitch and these simple goals provided me with a life-saving opportunity. So I wanted to use that and try and inspire other people to kind of to do the same. And that's what we did. And why did we do it? Because we wanted people to realise that there is hope out there. There is a chance for change. There are, if you're in a difficult situation, there is that opportunity to get out of there. But people need inspiration. People need hope. And that's what's kind of lacking just now. In terms of our organisation, we deliver programmes all over Scotland. We try and tackle homelessness, mental health, addiction, people who are generally disengaged, or people maybe coming out of prison, rather than going back into an old haunt where it's likely they're going to get back involved in the same problems, offering them an alternative. And the role models, the kind of, so where the change happens sometimes is by looking around their peers. Because all the projects that we run, which is over 40 across Scotland, they're all led by former players, former street soccer, former Davids. They provide the inspiration. When someone who's maybe in a hostel or maybe sleeping rough or they're having problems with their mental health, they come onto the pitch and they see inspiration, because the coach that they're working with as their mentor, they can say, well, if he can do it, I can do it. I could stand here all day talking about examples. I'll give you just two. Alan joined street soccer about 4 years ago. Alan spent, accumulated 17 years worth of prison sentences. And he thought that he had no other opportunity in life, because he had been involved in gangs, selling drugs, taking drugs, causing damage to his family, damage to his community. So he thought his life had ended. He would never change. After getting clean from heroin, he came through the rehab program and he started engaging in our football project. He then went and got involved in one of our personal development programs and became a volunteer. Now, Alan spent probably 10 years running away from the police, but Alan suddenly found himself working alongside the police, working in difficult communities where there were social problems, and trying to address that using football. He then went on and got himself qualified, and he now works for the NHS, and there's a lot of you probably maybe work alongside him. But he spent until the age of 40, taken from society, taken from budgets, he was a cost to society, but now he's turned that around and he's putting back. He's using the mistakes that he made to help others not make those mistakes. He's paying taxes, he's paying rent, so he's a contributing member of society. That's just one example. We have another young girl, Fiona, who from the age of 13, 14 was surrounded in a world of heroin use, and all around her with family members, and ended up getting involved in heroin herself. A fantastic sports star at a young age, had all the potential in the world, but that potential was crippled because the support wasn't there for her, and again, society didn't look after her. So she went into a care home, and she came out at 18 with a heroin addiction. a wasted talent, a wasted life opportunity. But she was given that opportunity to flourish by people around her not giving up on her, supporting her, saying that, you know something, you're really good at that, giving her opportunities to prove that. Today, she's a qualified sports coach, she's a women's ambassador for the project that we work with, and she is an ambassador to every young person who's came through care or who's had difficult situations to say, you know something, things are bad just now, but it can be a lot brighter if people look after you and you take the opportunities that you're given. So flourishing people is a great example there, but also for communities. You know, there's a lot of problems in our communities in Scotland and across the world. I'm a big believer if you put something good into a community, the community will flourish. And I'm going to drink water now because I've got a really dry throat already. It must be the air conditioning. An example of how our community can flourish through doing something positive. We started a project which was aimed at providing opportunities for young people who were experiencing child poverty by providing free football sessions. But the beautiful thing about this project was it was entirely delivered and developed by the players that we work with during the day, the adults. They designed it, they helped deliver it, and they currently deliver it. And in Govan, where I'm from, there's a lot of social problems. There's a lot of good, but there's a lot of social problems. And we put a centre in there, and through that centre being there, there was a lot of refugee and asylum seekers had moved into that area, like anywhere in Scotland, because they get the worst opportunities because there's low demand housing, you know. But the Somalian kids who are in the Govan area didn't engage with the local kids from Govan. There was a real kind of barrier between them. They wouldn't engage with one another. They wouldn't play with one another. There was tension. But the football project we set up actually brought them together. And it was the community centre in Govan who said, David, you know, that's the first thing I've seen those kids play. All right, they're probably kicking lumps each other and that's football. But it's the first time they've started engaging with one another. And that's continued. I spoke to one of the mothers who was at the session, and she has two young sons. She can't afford to send them to the local football team because it costs money to do these things. But also one of her kids had ADHD. So youth clubs and youth centres and football teams didn't know how to deal with him. They just seen, he's badly behaved, he's not in this club. And that was the approach. But what she said was, Reagan loves that. He just comes down here, it's so much fun, and he's actually behaving better. Because she said, you know, the three guys in there that take the session, they're great with him. Those three guys, one of them, I was scared of growing up. He would cross the street. The other guy, he was homeless. And the other guy had just come out of recovery. But they were putting back in, they were doing something positive, and they actually had a great relationship because they'd experienced everything the kids have put on there. So why is there a need to use football to help people flourish? Why is there a need for street soccer? Well, for me, it's about poverty. This lovely country, Scotland, and you'll watch Visit Scotland and you'll see all the nice castles and the nice bridges and the lovely streets lined in gold. But there's another side to our country. There's 1 in 5 children living in poverty. There's over 30,000 homeless people, you know. There's communities which I see and I walk down that people are scared to walk the street after a certain time. And that's down to gangs, it's down to drug cultures. It's not nice, you know. That's down to poverty. Because I believe that poverty leads to a lack of hope. And when you have a lack of hope, that's when negative behaviours can settle in. You know, mental health, addiction, crime. These are all based on poverty. I mean, there's a lot of medical people here. And the great Sahari Burns once said, during his early days being a GP, he would sign death certificates, murdered, liver disease, heart disease, overdose. But you know what he said? He could score a line through everyone and say, this person died of a lack of hope. So that's where we come in, and that's what we're trying to do. We're trying to create that change. But we can't do it ourselves. We're just a little organisation, and I'm just a little person on this huge galaxy. But I'm a big believer that if we all do a little, we can achieve a lot. You know, it's like the child, I don't know if you've ever read the story about the child was on the beach and he was picking up these starfish and throwing them in, and this gentleman walked up and says, what are you doing? Why are you throwing these starfish into the sea? There's thousands of them. He said, I want to help, I want to help. But he said, there's thousands. It's not going to happen. There's beaches all over the world full of starfish. And he just looked up with a kind of slint and said, yeah, but I just helped that one. But that's true. That's true. It's down to us in Scotland and the world. It's down to us to make a difference. And the only way we can do that is by being good human beings. Look outside your own doorstep and respect thy brother and thy sister, because we are good people. We must support one another in trying to do that little bit to help people flourish. Because like a flower, if the flower doesn't have the rain and the soil, it can't flourish. Just like a person needs support, it needs love, and it needs care in order to flourish. Thank you.